It may not mean nothing to y'all, but understand nothing was done for me. So I don't plan on stopping at all. I want this shit forever, mine, ever mine, ever mine. I'm shutting shit down in the mall and telling that girl she the one for me. And I ain't even planning the call. I want this shit forever, mine, ever mine, ever mine.
Stephen Hill, JustMyPicks.com, and I'm bringing you a special NFL preview for what's been happening going on lately in the NFL. Lately, the signing of Peyton Manning has been overshadowing of everything, pretty much in football. Pretty much the Denver Broncos went out to North Carolina. They sought out Peyton Manning. They got him. They bagged the biggest NFL free agent this year, possibly in the history of the NFL. This is a humongous move. It sends shockwaves not only through the AFC, but also through the NFC, because you have to look at it like this. He's in Denver. That's an easy division to win versus the Chargers, versus the Raiders, and pretty much the Chiefs as well. I'm looking at this as Peyton Manning has a chance to go undefeated in his own division, make the playoffs, and not only do what Tim Tebow did, but win more games going on to the Super Bowl. Peyton Manning, the biggest concern I have, can he stay healthy for the full season? Can that neck, being rejuvenated with two surgeries and neck surgeries in 1 year, is it possible that he stays healthy a full season? I know he's never been hurt before last year, but all I'm saying is my biggest concern is his health. I know anybody can throw against nobody, basically, with no wide receivers. You just got receivers out there, no defensive linemen playing you. But Peyton has to show me a few things before I pick him to be an actual Super Bowl contender this year. I like him as a Super Bowl contender. Being in this division, he instantly adds credibility to your offense. He instantly adds a field general. He instantly adds 4 to 5 extra wins on your team that you wouldn't have had because of fourth quarter drives, because of him making the other quarterback sweat and have to keep up with point-wise. The other thing I see, they have to get someone or a number one wide receiver, I'm thinking, via trade or either through the NFL draft to come in. I like Demaryius Thomas. I like what he brings, but he's not a number one receiver. So if you can get a number one receiver in Denver, I could possibly pick them for the AFC to win the Super Bowl. But that, besides that, it's Super Bowl or bust in Denver. With this move that they've made here and also trading Tim Tebow, that says that we're trying to win now, we don't care about the future, and we're mortgaging our future, banking on Peyton Manning being that guy. Also, in other news, Tim Tebow was traded to the New York Football Jets for a 3rd and 7th round pick. Also, Mark Sanchez's job, it just got a little warmer on that hot seat. Rex Ryan is not going for a PR move. He's going to save his job. By week 10, Tim Tebow will be the starting quarterback for the New York Giants. You can book that first. You heard it first on JustMyPicks.com. By week 10, Tim Tebow will be the starting quarterback of the New York Jets. Mark Sanchez just doesn't have what it takes to be the quarterback of the Jets. He has a soft mentality. He cracks under pressure. And his ego, it's bruised easily. It's done like he hasn't done enough to say, I'm the guy. Yes, you've gotten to 2 AFC championships, but it was on the back of that defense, not the offense, that won those games. And pretty much Tim Tebow, he's a Rex Ryan guy. He's a gritty guy. He's the guy that he doesn't care about the stats. All he does is win. We've heard it time and time again from Skip Bayless. All he does is win. I'm a Tim Tebow believer. He's a Rex Ryan guy that basically brings his lunch pail to work. He's the first one there, last one to leave. He fits the ground and pound system well. It's how many yards can you get me per play? It's can you run the ball 5 yards on first down, run the ball 5 yards on second down, run the ball 3 or 4 yards on third down. That's the kind of guy Rex Ryan wants. He's a team guy. He's a great guy off the field. I think that would help with a lot of locker room issues that they have going on. And he has people gravitate towards him. Tim Tebow is a hell of a person, a heck of a football player. And I see nothing but great stuff coming from him in this New York Jets offense. They're creating a special Wildcat package where he can thrive, and they actually want him. Tim Tebow in Denver didn't have the full support of John Elway and John Fox, and he knows what he has in New York. Rex Ryan will die for him. He'll go out there every week. He'll swallow the interceptions and swallow the losses. He'll take the blame for everything. So he knows that this Jets team actually wants him. They traded good enough stuff for him to get him. So to me, this is my dark horse for the NFL Super Bowl. With Tim Tebow on this team, if he's starting my week 10, they will get my bid as the Super Bowl champ. So I'm looking at all these things and factoring in. These are two great moves by two different franchises. One could be detriment for the future for the Broncos, but right now I think that you need to get Tim Tebow mania out of Denver for Peyton Manning to be comfortable. And also, the Jets, heads up, great play by the New York Football Jets. You can also check us out. This has been Just My Picks NFL preview of what's been happening lately in the NFL. You can also check me out on justmypicks.com. Read my articles. Tell me what you think. Leave me some feedback. Also, you can follow me on Twitter at StephenAHill17. Also, you can check me out on YouTube. Subscribe to us. Tell us what you think. Leave me some comments. Tell me what you think. Hit that like button and subscribe for us. Once again, my Twitter is StephenAHill17. Thank you very much for checking us out today. Thank you very much. Remember to hit that subscribe button.